Hi, TCN students. I hope that you're having a wonderful winter break. This is Miss Emma, and I'm here to read you one of my favorite stories. The story is called Miss Nelson is Missing. It's by an author named James Marshall, and I love this book because it's so silly. I'm gonna get started. Miss Nelson is Missing by James Marshall. The kids in room 207 were misbehaving again. Spitballs stuck to the ceiling. Paper planes whizzed through the air. They were the worst behaved class in the whole school. Yikes. "Now settle down," said Miss Nelson in a sweet voice. But the class would not settle down. They whispered and giggled. They squirmed and made faces. They were even rude during story hour. Look at this kid standing on their head. That is so silly. And they always refused to do their lessons. "Something will have to be done," said Miss Nelson. I wonder what she's going to do. The next morning, Miss Nelson did not come to school. "Wow," yelled the kids. "Now we can really act up." They began to make more spitballs and paper planes. "Today, let's be just terrible," they said. "Not so fast," hissed an unpleasant voice. A woman in an ugly black dress stood before them. "I am your new teacher, Miss Viola Swamp." And she rapped the desk with her ruler. "Where is Miss Nelson?" asked the kids. "Never mind that," snapped Miss Swamp. "Open those arithmetic books." Miss Nelson's kids did as they were told. They could see that Miss Swamp was a real witch. She meant business. Right away, she put them to work, and she loaded them down with homework. Oh my gosh, they each have so many books that they have to take home. It's a lot of homework.
"We'll have no story hour today," said Miss Swamp. "Keep your mouth shut," said Miss Swamp. "Sit perfectly still," said Miss Swamp. "And if you misbehave, you'll be sorry," said Miss Swamp.
The kids in room 207 had never worked so hard. Days went by and there was no sign of Miss Nelson. The kids missed Miss Nelson. I wonder why they're missing her so much. Probably because Miss Swamp is a very mean teacher.
"Maybe we should try to find her," they said.
Some of them went to the police. Detective McSmog was assigned to the case. He listened to their story. He scratched his chin. He said,
"I think Miss Nelson is missing."
Detective McSmog would not be much help. He didn't help them solve their problem. Other kids went to Miss Nelson's house. The shades were tightly drawn and no one answered the door. In fact, the only person they did see was the wicked Miss Viola Swamp coming up the street. "If she sees us, she'll give us more homework." They got away just in time.
"Maybe something terrible happened to Miss Nelson. Maybe she was gobbled up by a shark," said one of the kids. But that didn't seem likely.
"Maybe Miss Nelson went to Mars," said another kid.
But that didn't seem likely either.
"I know," exclaimed one know-it-all. "Maybe Miss Nelson's car was carried off by a swarm of angry butterflies."
But that was the least likely of all. The kids in room 207 became very discouraged. It seemed that Miss Nelson was never coming back, and they would be stuck with Miss Viola Swamp forever.
They heard footsteps in the hall. "Here comes the witch," they whispered.
"Hello, children," someone said in a sweet voice.
Who could it be?
It was Miss Nelson.
"Did you miss me?" she asked.
"We certainly did," cried all the kids. Where were you?
That's my little secret, said Miss Nelson. How about a story hour?
Oh, yes, cried the kids.
Miss Nelson noticed that during story hour, no one was rude or silly.
What brought about this lovely change? She asked.
That's our little secret, said the kids.
Oh, look how nicely they're sitting and listening.
Back home, Miss Nelson took off her coat and hung it in the closet, right next to an ugly black dress. When it was time for bed, she sang a little song.
I'll never tell,
she said to herself with a smile. The end. Oh, just kidding. There's one more page.
P.S. Detective McSmog is working on a new case. He is now looking for Miss Viola Swamp.
Where did she go? All right, TCN students, I hope you loved that read aloud. I hope you can figure out a fun connection that happened on these last pages. Come find me and tell me about it after winter break. Bye.